I'm Jimmy Whitworth. I'm Professor of International Public Health at the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine.
My name is James Soka Moses. I'm a medical doctor. I worked in two general hospitals, Redemption Hospital and ELW Hospital, located in Monrovia. I work mostly in medical emergency, and I see patients of all ages and all infections.
A public health emergency of international concern is the World Health Organization's highest level of alert. The most recent have been Ebola in West Africa and Zika in Latin America. In the case of Ebola, public health emergency of international concern was called because we had three countries neighboring each other in West Africa where this outbreak was out of control, where the facilities able to control it simply were not there, and there was an absolute need to have an international response.
The Ebola outbreak in West Africa actually reached Monrovia for the very first time in March, the 30th of March 2014. I was the lead clinician and caring for patients, but also supervising the rest of the staff. Monrovia was also the biggest epicenter for the outbreak in Liberia. In this unit, we had about a total of 125 staff, and about 40 of these were professional health workers. The rest of them were students, college students, and unprofessional people in the community who came and wanted to help. So it was very challenging to provide quality care for patients, but at the same time being able to keep staff safe. We also encourage them to avoid staying more than 1 hour in the Ebola treatment unit. I can tell you that was impossible to maintain, to ensure, because we had so many patients to attend to. At worst, we spent up to 4 hours in the Ebola treatment unit.
The school really has two main roles in outbreak response. Firstly, we're a major research institution, so that we gain in knowledge, we're better able to respond to that outbreak and better able to respond and prevent future outbreaks as well. But also, individual members of staff often will volunteer and join other agencies that are responding to the outbreaks. For example, with the Ebola outbreak, members of staff from the school went and worked with Save the Children, with Médecins Sans Frontières, Public Health England, and other agencies. Despite the fact that there were more than 10,000 cases that occurred, the amount of information we got out of how to respond to an outbreak, and particularly how best to clinically treat patients with Ebola, has been pitifully small. And that has been because we didn't have predefined research in place before we started.
With the information people had at the time that Ebola had a fatality rate of 90%, the natural response was people expect that you would die the next day. So the only calls you got was people trying to find out whether you're still alive or you're dead. Nobody wanted to interact with you. These were very challenging times for me personally. Suicidal thoughts start to run through your mind. You feel shame, you feel very guilty, you think you're worthless, you're no longer of value to society. And then to make it even more challenging to protect the rest of my family, I had to stay away from my children. I have two kids. My daughter Dara is 4 years old and my son Jesse is 7 years old. This was a world of your own, yeah.
Within outbreak response generally, the evidence base behind what we do is actually pretty limited. That's perhaps not surprising. It is difficult to do research in emergency situations, but it's not impossible. And I think if we're going to improve our responses for the future, we really do need to conduct research. I can say confidently that there will be future outbreaks and emergencies. What I can't tell you is what they're going to be, where and when. That's in their nature, they are unpredictable, but they will always be with us and we're never going to be able to completely prevent those.
There are many lessons learned from this outbreak. If we are given the support, we are given the training, our laboratories are improved, we are assisted in developing the public health systems, we can do better.
I think we are globally better prepared for outbreaks than we ever have been before. But it's been a slow process and there's still an awful long way to go.
I'm doing a master's degree in control of infectious diseases. As a medical doctor, you want to be this expert physician who gives the best medicines, who do the best physical exam. Ebola, without treatment, of course, Ebola doesn't have any cure. You lost your capabilities as a medical doctor. That has changed everything for me and the way I see people, not just patients, but everyone. I've changed my resolve to spend the rest of my life offering selfless service to community, to people.